know exactly what the future holds. For the Lord of all creation goes before me, and I can't rest assured He's in control. So I'll just keep on walking on this journey, following the one who knows the way, and those who does my favorite start away.
The ransom from heaven. Just to die for our sins. Yeah. So unconditional. the Prime Minister has visited and said that the Prime Minister himself is coming. But our Boosteros Church, for the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And then Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Can you imagine that? Are you ready?
When Jesus comes, will you meet him as your Savior? Or will you be among the unseen? When Christ appears in the clouds, take the believers with him. It will be too late then to get ready. You may have your name on the church record, but if you are not born again, you will be left behind when Christ comes.
I will remind you that there is no need for you to be lost. Jesus paid the ultimate sacrifice for our sins, and he invites you to come to him. Why not open your heart to him right now and take him as your Savior, so you will be ready to meet him when he comes. Brothers and sisters, let us be ready. Let us be watchful for the return of Jesus.
If you want to be ready for the Lord's return, then obey God's word. If you have sin in your life, confess it and turn from it. If you have wronged others, ask them for forgiveness. If you have hatred or unforgiveness in your heart toward anyone, go to them and make it right. Keep God's commandments and spread the prophecy to others. Whatever God tells you to do, do it now. This is what it means to be watching and waiting for the Lord's return.
The ransom from death.
Do we realize that? Yes. Are we prepared to display sacrificial love to those that we love? Can we see ourselves giving up our own lives for those we say we love? Think about it. Can you see yourself laying down your life for your mother, your father, your child, your spouse? Well, I have some news for you, because I know a man that did just that. Christ made the ultimate sacrifice by giving his life for us. Yes, for us, the wretched sinners that we are. The nation who turned their backs on him, the nation is so undeserving of his love and affection. Yes, he laid down his life for us.
What a wonderful thing my Jesus did. Sometimes it makes me sad to think I am disobeying, rebelling and not giving him my all when he paid the ultimate sacrifice. Christ embodies what it means to truly love without reservation. Oh, what love! John 3:16 states that God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son, that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Christ came so that we would be able to live, and it is because of his death that we are here today with a hope and a chance at redemption from our sins.
He loves us with an everlasting love. But at times it seems that the more he loves us, the less we love him. We take him for granted, only seeking him when we are in need or in trouble. Let this be a pledge today, to see God not only in times of trouble, but to see him always. Thank him for his act of great sacrifice, the gift of life that he has bestowed on us. For if it were you who were sent to save a dying world, would you have made that ultimate sacrifice? Well, praise God, the Lamb did.